dosto, it's me, Asha. It's raining today. I'm jumping in puddles with my friend Bunja.
Do you like to jump in puddles? I love jumping in the puddles. This is fun. Count the puddles with me in English. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 puddles. Now count the puddles with me in Hindi and Urdu. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 puddles.
Let's count them again in English. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now in Hindi and Urdu again. 1, 2, 3, 4. Great job!
Hey! My puddles are gone!
My puddles are gone too! Do you know where they went? Let's check my science screen. Let's learn about the water cycle. Water goes around and around this cycle. Did you know there's water in the air around you? You can't see it, but it's there. And in this form, water is called water vapor. One way water vapor gets in the air is called evaporation. When a liquid, like water, turns into a gas, like water vapor, that is evaporation. Our puddle was made of lots of water molecules. Some water molecules were moving faster than others. These molecules that were faster escaped into the air. Some things that affect the speed of water molecules and evaporation are temperature, pressure, and wind. The more water molecules that escape into the air, the smaller the puddle gets. Another way for water to turn into water vapor and enter the air is transpiration. That's when plants lose water from their leaves and the water vapor goes into the air. When water vapor turns back into drops of water, this is called condensation. Condensed water is what makes the clouds in the sky. Clouds and fog are made when water vapor in the air condenses into lots of little droplets that you can see. You can try watching a cold glass of water on a hot day. The water that forms on the outside of the glass comes from water vapor that was in the air. That's condensation! The droplets of water in the clouds grow bigger by combining or mixing together. When they get heavy enough, they turn into drops that fall to the ground as rain, snow, hail, or sleet. We call that precipitation. Once the water returns to the ground, you can find it in many places. Sometimes you see it in the ocean, a lake, or a river. There is even water underground called groundwater. This is called collection. It's called collection because the water collects in different places. Now you know some parts of the water cycle.
Wow! I can't wait until the next time water condenses in the clouds and makes it rain.
Me too! Thanks to the water cycle, we'll have more puddles to jump in. Shukriya dosto! Thanks friends for playing with us today. See you next time! Thanks for watching! Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel. Did you know that I'm in a book? Click here to see! Leave a comment below to let me know what Asha Love Signs video you want to see next.